हेलो एवरीवन, कंटिन्यूइंग विद आवर लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन कैड कैम यूनिट 3 पार्ट सेकंड. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर यूनिट वी आर फोकसिंग आवरसेल्फ टू कंप्यूटर एडेड प्रोसेस प्लानिंग. सो इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल बी फोकसिंग ऑन एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ कंप्यूटर एडेड प्रोसेस प्लानिंग. सो लेट स्टार्ट. सो टिल नाउ इन यूनिट 3, दैट इज कंप्यूटर एडेड प्रोसेस प्लानिंग, वी हैव स्टडीड वेरियस टॉपिक्स लाइक इंट्रोडक्शन टू कंप्यूटर एडेड प्रोसेस प्लानिंग, benefits of computer aided process planning, types of computer aided process planning system. So today we will be studying advantages and disadvantages of computer aided process planning. Also in this particular unit we will be covering few more topics like flexible manufacturing system and components of flexible manufacturing system. We will also be studying various topics in FMS which are the subcategories of flexible manufacturing system. So today we will be focusing on advantages and disadvantages of computer aided process planning. Till now we have studied various topics. So in benefits of computer aided process planning that we have already taken, it includes almost all the advantages of computer aided process planning. So let's start. So advantages of computer aided process planning. One thing very important, that both the advantages and disadvantages of computer aided process planning that we are going to discuss here will be as compared to the manual process planning. So this is a theoretical topic but very important. So advantages of computer aided process planning includes several factors. So as I said, computer aided process planning has some important advantages over manual process planning, which includes: number one, reduced process planning and production lead time. With the help of computer aided process planning, the planning timing and the production lead time both are reduced. Faster response to engineering changes in the product can easily be achieved. Greater process plan accuracy as well as consistency, as it is a computer aided process planning, so the accuracy and the consistency is very high as compared to manual process planning, even at repetitive tasks. Inclusion of up-to-date information in a central database, as the modification and the manipulation of data is very easy, so we can have up-to-date data and information at all times. Improved cost estimation procedures and fewer calculation errors, as it provides the high level of accuracy. So computer aided process planning has an improved cost estimation procedures which has lesser calculation errors. More complete and detailed process plans can be achieved with the help of CABP. Improved production scheduling and capacity utilization, and improved ability to introduce new manufacturing technology, as we have studied in group technology and various types of computer aided process planning, that on the existing system we can update and manipulate the procedures as well as the process. So it provides the improved ability to introduce new manufacturing technology and rapidly update process plans to utilize the improved technology. Also, it gives efficient elaboration and control through the reduction of resources, as we can use computer aided process planning with a high level of accuracy. So all the parts which are not required, or it helps in reducing the resources, which is very very important. It creates standardized procedures which helps through better knowledge. With the help of computer aided process planning, we can generate an effective SOP, that is effective standard operating procedures, which will help to reduce efforts as well as the cost of run for high works. And the last is, it lowers cost of software creation and also generative approach. We have already discussed in the types of computer aided process planning, that is when we want to make any new technology or any new process plan which is not an existing plan, so there also CAPP is very effective. There are certain disadvantages also of computer-aided process planning. Let's discuss. Disadvantages of computer-aided process planning. While compared with manual process planning, the CAPP system has following disadvantages. The inability to show special manufacturing techniques. Second, the initial cost of establishing a computer-aided process planning system is high. While compared with manual process planning, as manual process planning requires the experts, and whereas in case of computer-aided process planning, there is a huge infrastructure cost also added along with the existing manpower. So the initial cost is very high. Also, if the planner makes a mistake in the classification and coding, there will be no quality process plan. So though it is a computer-aided and an automated process, that is CAPP is an automated process, but manual efforts are very much required in the initial stages also and in between also. And if the planner makes any mistake, so the output will surely be depend on the type of process planning. So the quality is directly impacted, as in case of manual process planning, in between changes or runtime changes can be assumed, which are some of the assumptions that occurs during the process or manufacturing. So that can only be done with the help of manual process planning. So finally, what I mean to say is, sometimes in between human intelligence plays a very effective role. Sometimes in between human intelligence plays a very effective role in process planning, which is not possible through computer-aided process planning. So hope you are clear with advantages and disadvantages of computer-aided process planning. You can just pause this particular content and note down both the advantages and disadvantages of computer planning. So hope it is clear. So thank you so much. In the next lecture, we will be starting flexible manufacturing system, which is also a very, very important topic. And in flexible manufacturing system, different unit as well. We have several topics that we will be taking as a subtopics of flexible manufacturing system. So till then, thank you so much.